If you weren't a rice fan, you might be after today. Right now, on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, your favorite southern food takes a trip across the Pacific. A lot of flavor. I'm Tim Laird, along with Kevin Harned.
And Tim, we're excited to be in Kitchen Theater, tasting flavors that we've never had before.
So many things you could do with it.
Oh man, that's perfect.
Creamy goodness, woo!
It's a mix of home cooking with Japanese techniques, like you only find in Kentucky at Enso.
It means everything comes full circle.
The culinary genius behind it is with us today, sharing the secrets to what makes this such a tasty combination. It's time to get cooking right now on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. I'm Kevin Harned with my broadcast partner, Tim Laird.
And Kevin, it's a great day to be in Kitchen Theater because I'll tell you what, we're going to be cooking with a truly a rising star. Chef Lawrence Weeks is with us. The prestigious James Beard Foundation has named him one of the top emerging chefs in the nation. And it's easy to see why. After running Weta Michael's Kitchen at Honeywood in Lexington, he opened North of Bourbon in Louisville and started turning the heads of food critics immediately.
Tim, and now he's doing it again at Enso, a restaurant inspired by the chef's southern roots and his parents' connection to Asia. We're going to hear more about that and see what makes it such an amazing combination. So would you please help me say hello and a big welcome to Chef Lawrence Weeks.
Hello, Chef.
How are we doing? How are we doing?
Chef, good to see you again.
Nice
Absolutely.
To see you
Absolutely great to have you. How about this award you're getting? Is that exciting?
It is exciting. It's exciting. It's a lot of hard work that went into it, and there's a lot of people behind it, so I can't take credit for all of it.
Well, tell you what, well-deserved, and we're so happy for you, especially that you're here now in Louisville, and we got you here, and hopefully we're going to keep you here, right?
Oh, yeah. I'm here to stay. I'm here to stay.
Well, yeah, I want to talk about that, and I think everybody here sort of has an interest in knowing your past, but you call this home, so.
I've had a long journey through life. I've seen a lot of things. Grew up from a military family, so we moved around a lot when I was a kid. Born in California, moved to Kentucky, Louisiana, back to Kentucky. Atlanta, Georgia, Lexington, and back home. So I've always come back to Kentucky, so I always consider this home.
I know you're very busy because not only North of Bourbon, but now Enso. And talk about that restaurant a little bit.
So yeah, Enso is our second concept. We open with the idea of connecting the parallels between Southern and Japanese cuisine. Like I said, my parents were military, so they were stationed in Okinawa. And I have always lived, you know, in and around the South. So I saw a lot of parallels between the cuisines and wanted to highlight them.
All right. Well, what are we making today?
So the first thing we're going to work on today is our sesame turnip greens. Okay. So in Japan, it's traditionally made with spinach. But we had to take that southern twist on it, and turnip greens is one of my favorite things. So it's a blanched turnip green that's simply dressed in a sesame dressing, and then it's served chilled. Right. It's a great side dish.
Show us how to begin.
All right, so we start off with some washed and julienne turnip greens. During the season, we like to get these as local as possible or as regionally as possible. We just have some really well-seasoned water. We season it with salt.
And I know those are going to cook down pretty rapidly, too. I mean, it's pretty fast-paced, right, Chef?
Yeah, it's very fast-paced, so you need to have everything together. We have our salted boiling water, and on the side we have our blanching water, which is also salted as much as the blanching water, because once we incorporate the salt into the greens, we don't want to dilute it by putting it in unseasoned water.
And that'll stop the cooking too. So not only that, but it also will seal in that bright green color.
Right, right. It keeps that beautiful green color. So we let that hang out in the cold water. On the side, we'll make our dressing. Here I've got some mirin, which is a seasoned rice wine. We've got some bourbon barrel soy sauce, a little bit of sesame oil, and bené seed oil. Bené seed is the West African version of sesame seeds that we know it over here. A little bit more toasty, a little bit more of that sesame flavor. We've got that base going down, and then what we do is we whisk in our oil, and in the chef-y world, we call this an emulsification. So we're emulsifying our oil in, and that just means mixing it in to make sure that all the ingredients are well incorporated. And so we take our turnip greens.
Wring it out.
Squeeze all that water out.
Well, this is kind of a fun dish to make. Who knew?
Yeah.
And that's good to do when you're working with greens, whether it be spinach or turnips or greens and all these other ones, is to make sure you get that moisture out of there.
And we'll put it into our dressing. So we'll just give it a good mix. And like I said, this is a good side dish, a good starter. Top it off with some toasted benne seed. And like I said, that's a West African sesame seed.
How about this? You like that, everybody? The turnip greens will get a taste tester matched up to them when we come back on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. We've got more from Chef Lawrence Weeks right after this.
Find the highest quality seafood anywhere in town at Highland Fish Market in Middletown. From snow crab to smoked salmon, handmade crab cakes to halibut, our seafood comes in fresh every day. And we have a wide array of seasonings, artisan olive oils, and balsamic vinegars too.
Right now, save big on cooked shrimp. Buy 1 pound and get a second at half off.
Order yours today in store or online at highlandfish.com. Find out how fresh seafood can be at Highland Fish Market in Middletown.
Dine Company, the restaurant store, is one of Louisville's hidden gems. Located on Preston Highway, you'll find more than 30,000 square feet of retail space that's open to restaurants and residential customers. No membership required. Shop catering and bar supplies, cookware, utensils, and more in-store or online at dinecompany.com. Experience the difference our knowledge and services make. Dine Company, family owned and operated since 1982.
Tim Laird back with you on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, and it's time now to head out on the cocktail tour.
This time we're in Old Louisville at Buck's Restaurant, a staple of local fine dining, where all their signature dishes are served on mismatched china, along with live piano music, tons of fresh flowers, and craft cocktails at the bar. And right now I'm with Anthony, who's gonna make one of their signature cocktails. Anthony, what are we gonna make?
Today we're gonna make Kentucky Monk.
Oh, I love that. Well, show us the secrets to how it's made.
Okay, we'll start with Monk's Roll, 5th District. It is aged 6 years. We're going to do 1.5 ounces of it.
Delicious.
Nice aged more. Bourbon from Monk's Road.
Pour over ice. And we're going to use green chartreuse, traditional herbal liqueur made by traditional monks in France.
There's the tie-in.
Yes.
That's going to have a spicy taste to it, too, as
yes.
well. A little floral.
A little bit of lemon juice.
Looks like freshly squeezed
yes,
lemon juice.
Yes, it is. And honey syrup I made this morning.
Wonderful. That's going to give us a nice little sweetness to balance off all the flavors.
Correct. We're going to stir slightly. Mix all those good flavors together. Also, add a little touch of bitters to it.
Always a nice touch to a cocktail. It's like the chef's secret ingredient
is the bitters, right?
Yes.
You bet, Anthony.
And a lemon twist.
Beautiful. There it is, Kentucky Monk. I gotta give this a try, Anthony.
Okay.
First test your work here. Wow, Anthony, great cocktail, let me tell you.
Start the year off right with that.
I'll tell you what, the Kentucky Monk, this is a winner.
Excellent.
Cheers, Anthony.
Cheers. Thank you, Tim.
Stick around, because we have more Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs coming up.
The Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs Cocktail Tour is presented by The Amp at Log Still Distillery.
Hi, everybody. Kevin Harned back with you from Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. We've made our way back over to the PNC Bank tasting table. I've got Joanne with me here, a guest of PNC Bank, and with the Crane House. I want everybody to know what the Crane House is before we jump into the food. Won't you let them know?
Sure. Crane House is a local resource center that we promote the understanding of Asian culture through art, education, and outreach.
Yeah, and part of that happens to be with food, I assume.
Sure. We have, from time to time, a lot of activities, culture-related events, that food. Of course, we have some cooking class, and maybe some of you might know Chef at Sebastian Mole, that we have a lot of cooking class.
Very nice. Well, we've certainly seen Lawrence Weeks at work today. He's behind us setting up for the next one. Coming up, we're going to show you the duck fat rice and the almost risotto-like is what he called it. I want you to take a taste. Obviously, you've got that plus what he just made, the sesame turnip greens. Joanne, take a taste. I want to see how he did. A little bit of both on the fork, and here we go. We'll see how Lawrence Weeks did as we put this all together. Everybody in the audience will have a chance to take a taste a little later on. But how does it taste?
I can definitely taste the saltiness, which I think because the vegetable is usually bland, so I think that's a good touch. And also the rice is very smooth. I think the duck fat definitely adds this kind of a melting element.
Very nice.
Yeah, tastes very good.
All right. Well, we look forward to being able to share that with everybody, and we're about to learn the secrets. We've got more on that duck fat rice with Lawrence Weeks from Enso when we come back on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. How do you like that?
If you like Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs on TV, you'll love to see it in person.
Great time.
Fabulous.
Join us at the Secrets Kitchen Theater in Louisville's historic Paris Town.
This is a great experience.
I love that.
Watch top chefs reveal their secrets.
And I don't really hold back on this stuff.
And then taste everything they make.
I love this.
Delicious.
You can also enjoy all the other fun and shopping Paris Town has to offer while you're there.
We had a really good time.
Get your tickets now online at mintjuleptours.com. And hurry, because space is limited.
This is so good and so popular.
Watch Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs on TV and see it in person by going to mintjuleptours.com.
It was outstanding.
Make your reservations today.
Still cooking.
Appreciate you sharing the secrets.
Savor seasonal food and fine wine on Frankfort Avenue at Veronese with live jazz 7 days a week. Cocktails, dinner, and private events. Late night dining, too. The place to be is at the V. Veronese on Frankfort Avenue.
Kevin Harned back with you on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs, and right now it's time for another Wine Find with John Johnson at the Wine Rack.
This time I'd like to feature two wines that are both from the south of France that happen to be two of my personal favorites. The first wine is from a legendary winery called Vidal Fleury. So Vidal Fleury is the oldest continually operating grower and winery in the southern Rhone. In 1787, our own Thomas Jefferson visited the winery and proclaimed its wines to be, quote, justly celebrated. It's made from your key southern Rhone French grapes, and that would be Grenache, Syrah, and Mourvèdre. It gives you that nice essence that you get from the southern Rhone that they call Garrigue. Garrigue is like a combination of dried herbs and spices that's found in a lot of the reds from the south of France, and with Vidal Fleury's Côte de Rhône in particular. You get a lot of black currant on the nose with this wine and on the palate, a lot of red berry fruit. Wine is medium weight, very food friendly, and we think very wallet friendly as well. Very affordable. The next wine is something that we found 15 years ago, and that is from Mas de Gourgogne. So not a new addition to the store, but definitely a wine that we love to recommend. And if you haven't found this wine yet, we encourage you to give it a shot. It is made from all organically grown grapes. They've been farming organically for decades. This wine is Grenache, Syrah, Cabernet Sauvignon, and Carignan, and gives you a lot of similar qualities to the Vidal Fleury. It's a little beefier. You get some nice, like, dark chocolate notes on this wine. There's also a little touch of lavender in the aroma, and a good amount of black plum fruit. Sensational value, great food wines, both made with organically grown grapes, both great additions to your wine cellar. So come on down to the Wine Rack. Check out these fantastic French reds and our entire French selection. We think that you'll really enjoy what you find. Cheers.
Thanks, John. Stick around. We have more Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs coming up.
The Wine Rack, bringing you wines, beers, spirits, and cheeses of the world for over 18 years. Local, independent, and now offering delivery from the heart of Crescent Hill and online at wineshoplouisville.com.
Stop chasing your dog with a toothbrush. Use Pet Silver Teeth and Gum Spray, the natural solution for your pet's oral health and funky pet breath. Get Pet Silver online at petsilver.com.
Italian at its finest, Volare. Inspired cuisine by Chef Josh Moore. Intimate dining, private events, and year-round patio seating. Savor Volare. Cocktails and dinners 7 nights a week. Volare on Frankfort Avenue.
Tim Laird with you again on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs in our kitchen theater at Paristown. This is where Louisville stoneware was born more than 100 years ago. And Paristown is also home to our Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs kitchen theater, where we have a fun studio audience with us this time. And we also have an amazing chef with us today. Lawrence Weeks is here from Enso. The main dish is on its way, and this is just a duck fat rice?
Yeah, so we call this just duck fat rice. This is a semi-traditional Japanese dish.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, let's start. I see there's more than just rice up here on the counter.
There's a couple things that go into it. We make it look easy, but we start off with just some duck fat.
Can't go wrong there.
Hence the name.
Right in the pan.
And fat is flavor, and I love cooking with duck fat. I mean, it really is good, and you can buy it now, so.
Yeah, and then we throw in some local oyster mushrooms in the pan. And with those oyster mushrooms, we want to get a nice color on it before we season it. So we just toss it in that oil.
And what I love about those mushrooms, they have a little texture to them too, right? The oyster mushrooms, they're really nice.
Yeah, they have a nice texture to them. We get them from Frondosa Farms here in Louisville. I think they're right outside of Louisville and Shelbyville.
Yeah, excellent.
So once those mushrooms get a little bit of color on them, we put in some sliced shallot and garlic for some aromatics. At this point, that's when we start to add our seasoning, because we want the mushrooms to get all nice and roasted. So majority of the restaurants, we use diamond crystal salt, which is actually the least salty salt that you could buy. So it looks like a lot, but it's actually, it's not. It's a smaller granule, and that just helps it incorporate to the food better, and it doesn't take so long to break down.
All right.
So we've got some nice color. It's starting to sweat a little bit, and that's when we add in our rice. This is Carolina gold rice coming from Anson Mills as well, South Carolina.
And is that pre-cooked or is that raw?
So what we do is we use leftover rice from the restaurant in this dish.
That's a good thing to have if you have leftover rice, and you usually do, because when you make rice, there's always a lot of it.
And we like each individual grain to be separate.
All right, well, I'll tell you, while that's cooking down, we're going to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we will wrap up the duck fat rice. Stay with us. We're watching Secrets of Bluegrass Chef. We'll be right back.
River House Restaurant and Raw Bar, now open for lunch and dinner 7 days a week, featuring the cuisine of Chef John Veronese with a Southern-inspired menu and an emphasis on seafood with a spectacular raw bar. River House, right next to the water tower at 3015 River Road. Reservations recommended.
Make food service easier with help from Dine Company, the restaurant store. If you prep, cook, or serve food, Dine serves you. Shop Louisville's largest selection of new and used food equipment and smallwares in-store or online at dinecompany.com. Experience the difference our knowledge and services make. Dine Company, family owned and operated since 1982.
At Ditto's,
There's an open kitchen that lets you know something fabulous is cooking, like our sizzling stacked ribeye or raspberry chicken salad. Ditto's Grill. Delightful, delectable, delicious. It's gotta be Ditto's. Bardstown Road at Grinstead Drive.
Find the highest quality seafood anywhere in town at Highland Fish Market in Middletown. From snow crab to smoked salmon, handmade crab cakes to halibut, our seafood comes in fresh every day. And we have a wide array of seasonings, artisan olive oils, and balsamic vinegars too. Find out how fresh seafood can be at Highland Fish Market in Middletown.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs. Kevin Harned, Tim Laird. We're cooking here in our kitchen theater with Chef Lawrence Weeks. And as we went to commercial break, you were putting the rice in for the duck fat rice. Seems to be an important part of the dish.
Yeah. So we got the rice in, and we're just going to let that go a little bit, get coated with all that fat. So It's, like I said, each individual grain is coated. So what we're going to do next is we're going to go in with some mushroom stock. So we just take some dry mushrooms, rehydrate them, add a little bit of soy sauce, some garlic, some ginger, and make a nice vegan mushroom stock.
That'll be a nice compliment to the dish too. Yeah, absolutely, another flavor element.
And if you want to do it without any duck, you could definitely do it with no duck and no cream, maybe add some coconut milk instead, and then you've got yourself a vegetarian or vegan dish.
Well, and we still have to remember, this is just the base, because on top of this, we're going to put the turnips.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So we're going to get that going. While that's reducing, we add a little bit of matsutake mushroom shoyu or soy sauce. Matsutake mushrooms are a Japanese mushroom. They also call them pine mushrooms. We add a little bit of our shiotare, which is a salt-based sauce, seasoning sauce. It's a little bit of sake, some salt.
This has a lot of earthiness to it with the mushroom and the mushroom sauce and the stock, I'm thinking, right?
Yeah, it's definitely a real meaty umami dish. We hit it with a touch of cream.
Thicken it up.
Yep. And we just let it go for a little minute.
Want that little to reduce and go there. And so Enso, where does the name come from?
Enso actually came from one of our partners. It's a Buddhist symbolism for one single brush stroke. So it means everything comes full circle. I've come and I've left Louisville so many times and I always come back home. So coming back the final time, it felt like everything was coming full circle. For me going to culinary school, going to high school here, getting my chops in town and leaving and learning more. It kind of brought me back to where I am now to finally open up a couple of restaurants here in town.
That's good. And it seems as though you're a good family man. Your mom's close by here, and I know that your family's important to you.
Absolutely. Yeah, you got to have family and friends in this life.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it's starting to thicken up. That rice is starting to absorb the cream, absorb that stock a little bit. And what we're going to do is help it along by adding a little bit of Parmesan cheese.
Mm-hmm.
When I say a little bit, a lot of it.
Yeah.
That's good.
Oh, man.
This is going to be delicious. You can tell. Creamy. Like you said, like that risotto, where you have that nice creaminess and, Oh.
A lot of flavor, just packed with flavor.
Yeah, so one of the trends in Japan right now is actually Italian food. So this is kind of where that inspiration came from.
Okay.
It's Japanese, Italian. So we've got some duck. I'm actually going to turn the heat off. Put our duck in.
Wow, that's a good portion. That's great.
Stir that in nicely.
Incorporate it with that cheese and the rice.
Mm-hmm.
That looks delicious.
And this is duck confit, by the way. This is leg and thigh that we confit.
Oh, so cooked in its own fat?
Cooked in its own fat, and that's actually where we get the fat for the rice. So.
That does come full circle.
Absolutely.
Look
everything
at there.
Comes full circle.
It does.
I see you catching on, Tim. We add a little bit of scallion in there for flavor. And then just to brighten it up, We'll add some lemon zest.
That's good. When you have all that cream and other ingredients, just have a little lemon zest to brighten it up and flavor. Boom.
Yeah, you know, it's very hearty, so you don't want to muddle it down too much and have too many bold flavors. So all that cheese.
Wow, that came together fast. Like you said, that did come together quickly.
Mm-hmm. Boy, it looks amazing.
So I think we're at the point where we can plate it up.
Let's do it.
Excellent.
We'll just take a couple scoops of this duck fat rice.
Oh, look at that creamy goodness.
Doesn't that look good? If you weren't a rice fan, you might be after today.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
I don't know how you could not be a rice fan.
Oh.
So many things you could do with it. We hit it with a little bit more raw scallion on top because you want to have that fresh flavor. These are fried crispy onions. You can get these from the Asian grocery. They're amazing on everything.
I learned about those from green bean casserole. Remember you get those?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, goodness.
Those crispy onions on top.
And then if you don't mind me handing that duck fat. We'll take a little bit more of that duck fat.
Oh, yeah.
Just for mouthfeel.
Oh, yeah.
And what fat does when people say fat is flavor, fat actually helps flavors wash across your tongue and it carries flavors longer. So if you have something that's a little, you call it lean, if you add a little bit of fat, some olive oil, some butter to finish, it's actually gonna help those flavors linger on your palate a little bit longer.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of Italian cooking. That's where they end with a little bit of that olive oil that goes on top. And
absolutely, yep. A little bit more cheese.
Of course.
And then just to make it a little bit lighter, we'll little bit of lemon zest. And that's all she wrote.
Wow. There you have it, the duck fat rice.
Woo!
That will make a great pairing with the sesame seed turnip greens too. So that's gonna be a nice pairing together.
Tell us again where you're located, when we can find you down at Enso.
So at Enso, we are located at 1758 Frankfort Avenue. We are right on the end towards Story Avenue.
Okay.
You can catch us between 4 o'clock and midnight, Wednesday through Saturday, and on Sunday, 4 o'clock until 10 p.m.
Yeah. Perfect.
All right, Lawrence Weeks, everybody. We've got to say goodbye. Have you had fun today? We hope so. If you'd like to be a member of our audience, it's easy to do. Log on to midjuleptours.com. For Tim Laird, I'm Kevin Harned. We'll see you next time on Secrets of Bluegrass Chefs.
Of Kentucky in Nashville, Tennessee with Mint Julep Experiences, the local leader in Southern luxury travel. Get exclusive access to bourbon and whiskey distilleries, elevated culinary and mixology experiences, private barrel selections, and much more. Let our team take the hassle and worry out of your trip planning with our dedicated experts handling the curation of the entire itinerary and transportation. The purpose of fun is to have some. From Bourbon City to Music City, come immerse yourself with Mint Julep Experiences.
Authentic Mexican cuisine at Gustavo's, with 5 locations, including one on Hurstbourne Parkway. It's food that goes way beyond burritos and tacos, with everything from sizzling fajitas to seafood. The bar is stocked with bourbon and one of the best selections of tequila in the area, and Gustavo's own Vida de Reyes Mexican lager, with a hint of jalapeno. Taste and feel the authenticity at Gustavo's Mexican Grill in Crestwood, LaGrange, Prospect, Norton Commons, and now on Hurstbourne. Open every day for lunch and dinner. Gustavo's Mexican Grill.
Stop chasing your dog with a toothbrush. Use Pet Silver Teeth and Gum Spray, the natural solution for your pet's oral health and funky pet breath. Get Pet Silver online at PetSilver.com.
Originally in Tribeca, New York City, Rock is now in Louisville. Rock offers homemade and fresh quality food with an extensive wine and bourbon list. I will ensure that your Italian experience will be memorable. Rock on Barstown Road. Ciao, a presto.
Olive oil is an essential part of a healthy, low-cholesterol diet, and it comes in all flavors at Z-Olive, home to the finest extra virgin olive oils from around the world. And you can try all of them before you buy. Z Olive also has a wide variety of fine balsamic vinegars.
Great locale flavorings for everything from ice cream to steaks, marinades, and glazes.
Z Olive makes the perfect gift, or make it your secret ingredient. Taste the finest at Z Olive in Westport Village.